This is a Raspberry Pi 400, a computer inside a keyboard. Today, I'm going to show you how to install Kali Linux on the Pi 400. First, open a browser and type Kali ARM download. Look for the Offensive Security Linux download page. Here, all Linux ARM images can be found and downloaded. Scroll down to Raspberry Pi Foundation. The 64-bit image can be loaded on the Pi 400. However, from my testing, I've had Wi-Fi issues, slow response, and lag when using the 64-bit OS. From other forums, there are some known issues with this file. Instead, I chose to use the 32-bit file. You can also download from the torrent link, which is generally quicker. Wait for the file to download and complete. I like to install my OS image with the Raspberry Pi imager. It's free to download. Alternatively, you can use Balina Etcher, which is also free and a great little tool to install an OS image. Heading back to the Raspberry Pi imager, I first like to erase my current SD card. Give it a clean canvas. Select Erase, followed by choosing your current SD card. If you have multiple cards, pick the right one. Follow the prompts and wait for the format. Now to install Kali. Click on Operating Systems and pick Use Custom. Search for the Download Kali Linux OS image. Select and open. Choose the correct SD card you want Kali to be installed on and click Write. Raspberry Pi Imager will write the OS onto the card and will take around 10 minutes to complete. Once completed, eject the SD card and insert into Raspberry Pi 400. Now you want to set up your Pi 400 system. I'm using Magedock Portable Monitor. Plug the mouse, Pi 400 power adapter and HDMI cable to your monitor. It's now time to power up the Pi 400. The first boot will take some time due to partitioning and setup by Kali. The whole process is automated and will take around 5 minutes to get to the login screen. The default login and password is Kali and Kali. Once you're in the desktop, you can set up your Wi-Fi, personal preferences and folders. As you can see, this edition of Kali comes with a host of applications for security, forensics, hacking and coding. A lot of cool tools to try and explore. Don't forget to update and upgrade your Kali by opening a terminal window and typing sudo apt update, followed by your Kali password. Then to upgrade the file and applications, type sudo apt upgrade. This can take around 10 to 20 minutes to complete on the first run. I've already completed it, so it has finished quickly. And that's how you install Kali Linux on one of my favorite computers, the Raspberry Pi 400. If you need more information, leave them in the comment section below, and please like and subscribe to this channel for more videos. Until next time, thanks for watching and happy coding.